Hi everyone, welcome to Python learning series for network engineers. This is the second video on CSV. In the first video, we have seen the overview of this script. We showed how to execute this. You can see here, it is reading this CSV. So config in column.csv and fetching all the data and executing that on device. So you can see here, is communicating with each device which I mentioned in the CSV file. So in this video we'll see how I have generated this output. This is the output which I'm generating from the CSV and executing it on each device. So let's see how to get this formatted data by reading CSV. So initially I'll be explaining that by reading the raw content. Here you can see the configuration is in raw format and we'll use reader, and in the next video we'll see how to use DictReader for making it in the same format, in this format. So let's start writing the script. So you can see here just completed the command execution, and here if you see I had some empty spaces and it tried to remove all the spaces. You can see here there is no space while executing the command. Now let's start writing the script using reader. So first I'll import the library from CSV. Import reader, and I'll read this file first. Because this will, understanding the logic will help you to customize the script based on your requirement. So first we'll try reading this format and then we'll move into the column based. So let me go to this with open, and I'll give the file name 01. Underscore config in raw.csv. My script file and CSV files are located in same location, so I can just give the file name here, and I'll be doing only the read operation, and I'll call this as CSV file, and I'll do the reader operation here. I'll call this as variable CSV content equals reader. I'll use reader method here, and this CSV file. Let us try printing this CSV content. Let me try running the script. So you can see this is a CSV reader object. So we should be able to iterate through that. This is going to be a list. So for, I'll call device in the above content, CSV content. And let us try printing the device. Now you can see I'm just reading the raw file here. So this file I'm reading, and each row here it is coming as list. So let me copy this, and the end result I need is this data. I need to convert it into this format. If I give this format in my script, it will execute on all the devices. So I'll try to convert this number of list into this format. So let's start writing the script. So here you can see everywhere the first column is device IP. So what I'll do here, I'll just try giving only 0, that is a 0th element. So you can see here I'm getting all the device IPs, but here I have some empty space. Because of that, you can see a blank space here. So let us handle that. If device 0, so we'll give a not here. That means it is, if it is empty, don't add the data, just continue. Let us try running it again. So now you can see it skipped that empty field. Now we need to create a dictionary. If you see this data, you can see all these IPs I'm adding as a dictionary key. So what I'll do here, I'll just try to create a dictionary, empty dictionary here. If the device IP, so now we know device 0th element is IP, so here we can assume this as the IP address is not in, and I need to initialize a dictionary here. The final output dictionary I'll call it as conf dict dict not in conf dict dot keys. So each time when I get an IP, it will go and check whether that is available in the this dictionary's keys. If it is not available, it will add it into this dictionary. So conf dict, if it is not available, it will add. Again, the device 0 is our device IP, so I'll give this equals an empty list I'll try creating here. Now what will happen, each time when an IP comes, it will go and check whether that key is there. If it is not there, it will add an empty list as a value for that. So let's try printing it. Print conf dict. Let's try running it. So you can see here, okay, let me just remove this print. So now you can see I have received the key part. So you can see here this part is done. Now we need to get the configuration as a value for each IP. Now for that, if you see this, this will vary for each device. So there might be a difference in each line. If you see this, you can see in certain places it is going till L, K and J. So we need to exactly take till where it goes. So what I'll do here, I'll just give n equals length of device, because in this case each time this line, each one will come as a device. So length of device means it will vary, right? So let's try printing the length of device first, just for your reference. Now let's try adding some more columns here. I'll just give two exits. And let me save the file. Yeah. Let us try running it again. So you can see here, so it has taken the highest column number. So now we'll be getting the length of column, and now so we need to iterate through that. So I'll call that as config. So before that, what we can do, we'll just try printing the configuration here. Let me just give a print device. Device of 1. So you can see here it is printing the first device's configuration 4 times. Now if I give 2 here, let's have a look. So you can see here it is printing the config terminal, and let's try giving 3. So you can see here it is changing for each device. So you can see here it is changing for each device. But now we need to add this under our dictionary for each key or IP of the device. So now let's create a for loop for that. So we'll call that as for conf in, again we have taken the length of the complete list, so we'll give range and we'll give 1 to n. First let's try printing the conf. It is just an integer. So you can see here it is printing 4 times this integer, but we just need this integer for getting the device configuration. So what we'll do, devices, and we'll give the conf here. So that means this conf will be looping from 1 to 13. So now let's try printing. So now you can see it is printing configuration of individual device, but it even includes the empty space as well. So what we'll do, we'll just try writing a logic for that. If not device, conf, continue. Now let's try running it. So you can see now it has removed all the empty spaces, but we need to add this as the value for our each IPs. So what we'll do, we know our IP is here, and that is going to be the key of the about dictionary. So IP dot append, and the value is going to be this. So each line of config will come and store here. Now it will append the complete configuration here. So now let's try running it. Now you can see I got it in a proper format. IP is my key and the configuration list is my values. You can see it has removed all the empty spaces. Now let's print it using pretty print. Now if you take this output and compare it with this, it will be same. Both will be same. Now let's add our SSH logic to this. Let me just copy only this part, paramiko and SSH part, and put it in the new file which we have written. Here we need to import two more libraries, import paramiko and import time. So let's try executing our new script. And here in paramiko you can see, instead of using a password for security, I'm using SSH RSA key, and I'm just passing only admin, the username and the key. If you want to use password, you can just uncomment this and it will work with username and password. And here I'm testing the system host keys, but if you want, even you can add auto add policy for the missing keys. I have explained that in the paramiko video in detail. I'll add that video also in the description. Now let's try running this script. So you can see here, so it is executing command in the devices. So here, why it is printing this list is, I have given a print here just for the user reference. So here the conf dict IP I'm just printing, and executing commands are, I have given a description, so you can see the same thing here. So executing commands are. In the next video we'll see how to read the configuration which is defined in colon format and use the CSV reader. I hope this video was helpful. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.